Okay, so what we got here is the new elevator design for Buttonwood development. Notice the drive drum is set.
Shut the fuck up, Jerry. Jesus Christ.
That's the sorry motherfucker right over there that's over here disturbing me and shit.
Yeah.
He's the only motherfucker around here gets anything done. All right, so we got 2 inches. The bracket to the edge of the channel. This channel should be cut. Let's go ahead and cut it 15 inches the next time. The spool was a little short. The spool is supposed to be 14 3/8, the standard spool. This one I wound up cutting it at 13 7/8. But that's fine. Now the degree up here is 7 degrees. Because that's the same as the pitch on the cable winder. So, then the hole in the drive pipe, this hole right here, gets pulled out 4 9/16 from the edge of this bearing over here. From the outer edge of this bearing to the center of that bolt hole, 4 9/16. Then we come down here. Come down here. I really need a fucking handle for this camera. Come down here. And to lay out that winch plate pipe mount, come from the top of the 10-inch plate, down 16 inches to the center, and then up 1 1/4. We'll come up 1 1/4 to the center. Remember that, 1 1/4 to the center by 16 inches from the top of the plate. Okay, what else did I... Okay. I got that written down there. This is the left-hand rail with a winch to the outside. It counter-rotates on the travel when traveling up. With that counterclockwise up travel. And then, what else? Oh, well, I got you here. Let's go over and take a look at the steps I just got done building this morning. These are a set of slider steps with a handrail. They came out pretty nice. They always do. Just a standard set. 8-inch high steps, 24 inches wide, and they get these little brackets right over here that will get attached to the dock like this, something like this, those brackets get attached to the dock, and then the steps will slide in and out. Steps will slide in and out. That'll be like what it looks like when it's finished, when it slid back onto the dock, and then when it slid off of the dock, obviously. Let me go to the other side and see if I can't get it to slide over here. And when you slide them off of the dock, bam, the cantilever's over the edge of the water. Looks like, voila. Not too bad a setup. Let's see what else we got going on in here. There's some of our 10,000 pound channel lifts. Bundle of the drive pipe for them. Oh, there's a run of 12 foot cradles, 5x8 beam. Oh, there's a bundle of 5-inch channel, looks like, for 1, 2, 3, 4. 7,000 pound lift we're building. There's some more 12 foot cradles. Oh, over here on those benches, we also got about, looks like 2, 4, 6 sets of 20-foot platforms we'll be building, walk boards. Let's see that over here. Rack of aluminum. We got some channel lifts already built up there. Those are standard 10,000 pounds, 12'3" outside to outside. I don't know if those are in focus or not.
This is a great way to help others lead an active, healthy lifestyle. Kaiser University.
There's a new weld on here.
Class at a time scheduling. And
this is my design.
For those who qualify. For more information about
saying, over here, there's some welded on right there. And a set of the cradles. Oh, let's go out here and see this. Come out here and take a look at this set of sailboat cradles I did. Sailboat cradles right here. They came out pretty nice. Fish plated in each corner, bolted. And the center beam is over here. There's a run of cradles right over here. There's the center beam. We still need to clean them up. Oh, there's the 40,000 pound cradles that just came back from Galv that I showed in a video earlier. And there's a bundle of, or a run of 10,000s and 7,000 pound channel lifts getting ready to go out to the Galv. Here's the Buttonwood mast for that elevator rail that was inside. And a set of aluminum angled shallow water angle one side cradles. Mosey on down here. And there's a run of the 12'8" 10,000 pound top beams. They run first bearing. It's 13 and 13. Dead drop is 15 3/4. Go down there, first bearing, or the dead drop is 123.5, 123 3/4, 136.5 to the outside of the second bearing, the last bearing. And the overall length of the beam is 12'9". There's a set of boathouse beams right there, getting ready to go out to Galv. And there's our jet ski rails right there. Those are a pain in the fucking ass to make, I'll tell you what. Let's see what else we got down here. Oh, the Alpha 203 top beams. See these little short ones in a pile? Those are 6-footers. I'll explain more of that about that later. Those actually get a, it's like a V set of cradles. Here's a 30,000 pound lift for Ronnie. Set of 16-foot cradles with a new design on the top, on the ears for the tops, or for the, so we don't have to use shackles in the water anymore. They just the thimble comes down, dead drops to the second stainless steel bolt right there. And it's an 8-piling lift, 4 pilings on this end, 4 pilings down that end, 12'10" cross brace and center beam here. What else we got? There's one of them 12'8", 10,000 pound top beams for Calm. There's a rack of 7,000 pound channel lifts and 7,000 pound top beams. And there's another run at the 10,000s over there. My steel rack and whatnot. All right, I gotta go for now.